I pray every day. I go to church every day. I just want him to get better. I miss him.
Dee Dee Rager is lost without her husband, John, inseparable since high school. But now the 47-year-old's at MetroHealth Medical Center after an unprovoked and savage attack. John's sister thinks they were trying to kill him.
They were out to do as much bodily harm as they could.
John and Dee Dee are mentally challenged, but he works hard every night at this Cleveland Heights bakery until 1 in the morning, taking the bus and a bike to get home to Collinwood. But last Wednesday, a flat tire forced him to walk. Police say he was jumped by several people on East 152nd Street in Cleveland.
And luckily there was a good Samaritan angel that did call the police and then yelled to scare the group of men away.
As John was walking home, he was picking up empty beer cans along the way, something he often does to supplement his income. But those beer cans and the smell of alcohol actually confused the responding officers when they first arrived.
They thought he was a drunk.
The initial report calls the injuries self-inflicted, says officers asked John if someone did this to him, and he said no. The family says John was semi-conscious, and toxicology tests showed no alcohol or drugs in his system. The report has been amended, but the family is upset, even though police say they've taken the case seriously since the beginning. John has two subdural hematomas, skull fractures, lacerations, bruises, and no short-term memory.
We don't know if he's ever going to be able to recover from this.
They don't know if John will ever be able to volunteer again at church or at the soup kitchen with Dee Dee. The family says they need help, and they started this Facebook page called John Needs Justice, hoping someone will call police.
I just want this person, whoever did this, to come forward.
In Cleveland, Suzanne Stratford, Fox 8 News.